Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve error when running the command npm install in react.js. So here you can see that I'm getting this code ERESOLVE could not resolve. So I'll be showing you four simple ways and some commands to solve this issue. So let's get started. So the first command is npm config set legacy peer dips true, or you can just run the command npm install legacy peer dips. So for example, in case if you are trying to install npm I cores or any other npm package alone, you need to run npm I that package name, and at the end you need to add this particular thing. So first let me go with this command. If you can't see, let me just like zoom in a bit. So this is the commands. So first let me go with npm install legacy peer dips. I'll just copy this, and if I just go here and hit enter, so this time here you can see, right, I'm having my node modules over here, packages are getting installed. So here you can see, right, so this command is working perfectly. So in case if you're using the second command, run the second command, and after running the second command, you need to run npm install again, all right? So this is the second command, and third command is going to be npm install hyphen hyphen force. So the reason why I have included that command is because here you can see, right, when I got that error when running npm install, here it says run this command with hyphen hyphen force or hyphen of hyphen legacy peer dips. So try running this npm install hyphen hyphen force. The next try that you can do is cleaning the cache, that is the npm cache, npm cache clean hyphen hyphen force. If you are still getting this error, try checking your folder path in Visual Studio Code. So here you can see that I am inside my first project, and within the first project I'm having my package.json and these files. So if you are like one folder behind, and if you try to run npm install, that time also you may be getting some errors. So try correcting your folder location. And final thing is, you need to just try closing and opening, or basically restarting your Visual Studio Code. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Node.js, MongoDB, MySQL, CRUD operations. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.